And joining me now is California Lieutenant Governor Gavin Newsom, who came to Washington to hear the Prop 8 case be argued before the Supreme Court, and also Brian Brown, co-founder and president of the National Organization for Marriage. Mr. Lieutenant Governor, if I may, I want to play you something Justice Samuel Alito said in arguments today.
Traditional marriage has been around for thousands of years. Same-sex marriage is very new. I think it was first adopted in the Netherlands in 2000. So there isn't a lot of data about its effect. And it may turn out to be a good thing. It may turn out not to be a good thing, as the supporters of Proposition 8 apparently believe.
So does Justice Alito have a point? This is relatively new. You only started handing out marriage licenses in 2004.
Sure, it's absolutely factual what he's asserting. That said, what's the constitutional question? I mean, that's what we're supposed to be adjudicating, whether or not it's constitutional to deny people based on their sexual orientation the ability to enter into the institution of marriage. That said, let me just assert, I know no evidence whatsoever in places like Spain since 2005 and other countries of the world where marriage as an institution has been under any sort of assault or the sky is falling in. Certainly in Massachusetts and elsewhere in America, we haven't seen that somehow there's been this devastating or deleterious impact because same-sex couples are entering in the same institution that Brian and I have been afforded in our lives.
And how about that, Brian? We have not seen traditional marriage, opposite-sex marriage, harmed in any way in places where it's taken place, have we?
Well, that's not true at all. I mean, one need only look to what happened in Massachusetts, where Catholic Charities Adoption Agency, one example, is put out of business because when you redefine marriage, you redefine it for everyone. It isn't just that couple. And you basically are now saying that religious organizations and individuals that know that there's a truth, that it takes a man and woman to make a marriage, just saying that is viewed as discrimination. So in Illinois, in Massachusetts, in Washington, D.C., religious organizations told that they can't adopt children because they're discriminating by not placing kids with same-sex couples. We've seen benefits fights. We've seen businesses that, for example, do weddings being told, if you don't do same-sex weddings, again, you're discriminating. What you're doing is you're putting a brand new idea into the law that there is absolutely no difference between a man and a woman coming together in marriage and two men or two women, and that those of us who think that there is a difference are the functional equivalent of bigots.
First of all, Illinois doesn't have same-sex marriage, so you're...
It only took civil unions in Illinois. Civil unions shut down the adoption agency.
I don't know. You and I don't see the world with the same set of eyes. I actually have extraordinary respect and admiration for same-sex couples and loving people that care as much about their spouses as you and I care about ours. They care about entering an institution of faith, love, devotion, and constancy. And they believe that they have the rights under the Constitution of the United States, due process, equal protection, to enter into that institution. And I do find it interesting that people like George Bush themselves felt it was important to change the Constitution because, by definition, the president felt there was something wrong with it. He wanted to actually write discrimination or a constitutional amendment to ban same-sex marriage as a suggestive point that there's something in the Constitution that the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals agreed and the lower court in San Francisco.
Well, that is an interesting point, because if it were in the Constitution, there wouldn't be any need for a constitutional amendment.
But this is totally misreading the history. The reason that you need constitutional amendments is exactly because of what's happening at the United States Supreme Court. This is not a decision the court should be making. The people of the state of California have the right to have their voices heard. And the reason that constitutional amendments on the state level were passed is because activist judges at the state level, beginning in Massachusetts, were imposing their will on the voters and basically saying, we don't care what you think. This is coming whether you like it or not, and we're going to force it on you. The people have a right for their voice to be heard. This is an issue in which good people can have disagreements, but the reality is that it is not the majority of Americans who have voted to protect traditional marriage. You can't just say those people are discriminating and are bigots. The majority of Californians saying that they were discriminating by Prop 8, wrong.
Okay, very quickly, what do you think is going to happen based on the arguments today? Very quickly.
Well, I think that we're going to win. Traditional marriage will end up winning, both in Proposition 8 and in DOMA.
What do you think?
I think they're going to uphold the Ninth Circuit Appeal Court, and I think that decision will allow same-sex marriages as early as late June in California, and hopefully it will expand beyond that.